Hello friends, this is Priyanka. Today we are going to solve a problem on hydrostatic forces on surfaces. In this video, we are going to solve a problem about curved surface submerged in liquid. So first, I will read what is the given problem. A cylindrical gate of 4 meter diameter, 2 meter long has water on its both sides as shown in figure. Determine the magnitude, location and direction of the resultant force exerted by the water on the gate. Find also the least weight of cylinder so that it may not be lifted away from the floor. So this was the given question. We have to first find out what are the forces acting on the left hand side of the cylindrical gate, and then we are going to calculate what are the forces acting on the right hand side of the cylindrical gate, and then only we can find out what is the resultant force that is applied on the cylinder. So we will move for the first for the left hand side. So forces acting on left side of the cylindrical gate. Now, if we observe this here, this curve ABC is in contact with water. So, this water is applying a pressure force on this curve ABC. So, we have to refer this curve only ABC while we are taking here only left hand side of the cylinder. Now, we will use here the suffix 1 for the left hand side and suffix 2 for the right hand side, because we have made here the two parts of this gate. Why we are making the two parts? Because here the water level is different. Now, this is the curve which is in contact with water. That's why the force is in the inclined direction. So we have to resolve this force into two components, that is horizontal force component Fx and vertical force component Fy. So we will use here the suffix 1, that's why the components are Fx1 and Fy1. So first we will calculate the Fx1, that is the horizontal force component. So how to calculate this? That is the force of water. That is the here this water is in contact with this area. So force on water on the projected area, that is this curve ABC on a vertical plane. So we have to take the vertical plane for this curve ABC. So how to take? So here I have drawn three-dimensional diagram for this cylindrical shape, because the length is also given, that is 2 meter, and here is the curve ABC. So this is the three-dimensional diagram. So vertical plane means what? So if we observe here this area ACFE, so this whole area is the vertical section, or we can say vertical plane. So we have to find out what is the force of water that is applied on this projected area of this vertical plane. That means the water is in contact with this vertical plane. So this plane is the rectangular form. So if we observe, its height is 4 meter, because we know the distance from A to C is 4 meter and the length, that is 2 meter. So we have to take here. So we can say that this is the rectangle shape of 4 by 2 meter. So what is the formula for the calculation of this force? That is rho g A into h bar. So h bar means what? H bar means the distance of center of gravity point from the free surface of water. Now if we observe this AOC or this curve ABC, then where is the center of gravity point? So for this whole cylinder, if we observe here at the middle point, there is the center of gravity. So from what is the distance from free surface for this middle point? That is 4 divided by 2. Because we have to take from free surface of water. So here free surface of water up to a height of 4 meter, and this curve is also having height of 4 meter. So 4 divided by 2, that is equal to h bar, that we have to take. So we can simply put here values. So here area we will say A1, and h bar, that is we will say h1 bar. So 1000, that is rho, density of water 1000, A1, that is 2 multiplied by 4. So we have to take the area for ACFE. Then जी दैट इज 9.81 एंड एच वन बार दैट इज 1/2 दैट इज हाफ मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 4. सो वॉट इज द आंसर हियर दैट इज 1,56,960 न्यूटन. नाउ वी विल मूव फॉर द कैलकुलेशन ऑफ द एफ वाई वन. सो हाउ टू कैलकुलेट दिस एफ वाई वन दैट इज वेट ऑफ वॉटर सपोर्टेड बाय द कर्व ए बी सी ओ ए. So why we are taking this? So this is the imaginary part, because in actual there is no any water inside it that, but we are measuring the weight of water supported by this part A B C O A. Now because we are going to consider only left hand side part, so which part is in contact with water here? A B C, this part is in contact with water. So this part we have to refer, this part is in contact with water, and now we have to enclose this part. So how to enclose this ABC curve? That means we have to join this C to A, then this area is getting enclosed. So we have to find out what is the weight of water enclosed by this area ABCOA. So what is the formula for calculation of weight? Weight of water, that means rho into g into volume. So rho, because water is there, that means we have to take the density of water g, that is 9.81, and volume of this area a b c o a. So how to calculate the volume? So if we observe this three dimensional diagram, we have to first calculate what is the area of this abc. Now if we observe this abc is the half circle. So what is the area of this half circle? That is pi by 2 r square. So r means radius of this half circle is 2 meter. So I will write here r is equal to 2 meter. So we have to take area of the half circle, that is pi by 2 r square, multiplied by this length, because volume means what? We have to take this whole volume. That means we have to multiply with this length, that is equal to 2 meter. So when we calculate this, we will get here the answer 1,23,276 newton. So this is the FY1. Now again we will move for the next, that is the forces acting on right hand side of the cylinder. So this left hand side part is getting completed, that means we get here FX1 as well as FY1. So with this fx1 and fy1 we can calculate the f1. Then we will move for the right hand side part. So for the right hand side part, again if we observe here, this quarter circle is in contact with water. So this is also the curvature, and the force acting, or the force pressure force applied by the water on this curve is also in inclined direction. So again we will calculate here the two part, that is the resolve this force into two components, fx2 and fy2, because we will use here the suffix 2. So again we will move for the calculation of fx2. So fx2 means what? Again, force of water on the projected area of the curve CD on the vertical plane. So here the curve CD is in contact with water. So again we have to draw here the vertical plane. So here I have drawn three dimensional diagram. So this is the curve which is in contact with water, and what is the vertical plane? So if we observe here, if I extend this point D in the horizontal direction and point C in the vertical direction, then this point O, that is the point of intersection, will give us the center, that here is the point O. And in this way here is the three dimensional diagram. Now the length is given, that is 2 meter. So we have to extend this point D up to a 2 meter. So this is the length, this is the height, that is 2 meter. So this height C to O is given, that is the height of water. So if we project this curve on the vertical plane, now here in this diagram PCON, so this is the area for which the vertical plane of this projected curve. So for this area we have to consider this area ON, PC. So if we observe, this is the area for the square shape, that is 2 by 2. So we have to find out what is the area of square, and then H2 bar, that is the center of gravity from the free surface of water. Now how to calculate this H2 bar? So we have to only consider this curve from D to C, which is in contact with water, and here is the free surface of water. So for this height, that is from O to C, at the middle point there is the center of gravity G. That means we have to take half multiplied by 2. So if we put here the values, that is 1000 into 2 by 2. So here this area PCON is 2 by 2 into 9.81 into H2 bar, that is 2 by 2. So when we calculate this, we will get the answer 39,240 Newton. Now in the same way, again we will move for the calculation of the vertical force component FY2. So how to calculate this? So again, we have to consider the imaginary part, that is weight of water supported by this curve ODC. So again we have to find out. Now this is the imaginary part, because in actual, because this curve DC is in contact with water, so we have to enclose this curve. So how to enclose this? That is, this is the center point. So we will enclose this, that means here ODC is the area. So how to calculate the weight of water supported by this? So weight of water, that means rho into g multiplied by the volume of this ODC. So ODC volume means what? We have to first calculate area of this curve ODC, and then we have to multiply with this given length, that is 2 meter. So this is from this three dimensional diagram we will come to know. So what is the area? Now this is the quarter circle. So for the area, we will consider here as a O2. So here rho g into volume of ODC, that means 1000 into 9.81, and area means what? Now here pi by 4 r square, because this is the quarter circle, that's why we have to take pi by 4 r square multiplied by 2. So when we calculate this, we will get the answer 61,638 Newton. Now we will plot these calculated forces, that is Fx1, Fx2, Fy1 and Fy2. So for that we have to first find out what is the exact location for these forces. So how to find out? So we will first find out location of this Fx1. So the formula is that 2 by 3 multiplied by this whole height of the water, that is 2 by 3 into 4. And that is equal to 2.67 meter, and this is the height, that is 2.67 meter distance from the free surface of water. So we have to take that distance. That means here at the middle point the distance is for 2 meter, and after that 2.67 meter, that is below the middle point, here the exact location for this Fx1. So this is the horizontal force, that is in the direction of x. So I have to show here, this is the force Fx1. Now in the same way, we will find out the location for Fx2. So here Fx2 means what? Again the same formula is there, that is 2 by 3 into the height of the water, that is 2. So what is the answer here? That is 1.33 meter from the free surface of water. So here the middle point is 1 meter, and after that means below that there is the location for this Fx2. That means we have to take 1.33 meter from this upward horizontal line, because this is the line indicates the free surface of the water. So I will show here the location of Fx2. Now again we will move for the location for the force Fy1. So how to calculate this? Now Fy1, that is the vertical component of this force. So Fy1, there is the formula 4r by 3 pi. So r means radius. So what is the radius for this left hand side? That is y1 is for this left hand side of the cylindrical part. So what is the radius? That is 4 by 2, that is 2 meters. So 4 into 2 divided by 3 pi, which is equal to 0.8488 from the AOC towards left, because this FY1 was considered, that is suffix 1 was considered for the left hand side part. So we have to take this vertical force, that is in the direction, that is in the upward direction, but from AOC. This is the point AOC, because this is the vertical plane that we have to consider towards left. So here from this point O, I have to take the distance 0.8488 meter, and here I have to plot FY1. Now in the same way, we have to again find out FY2, that is the vertical force component. So if we observe again, the same formula is there, 4r/3π. So for this right hand side also, what is r? That is the radius of this curve DC, that is the distance OC we can say, and it is equal to 2 meter. So the same distance is there, that is 0.8488 meter, but this suffix 2 is used for the right hand side. So we have to take the distance from this point O towards the right hand side. So I will plot here FY2. So these are the forces, that is the, this is the location that we have to take. Then what is the resultant force in x direction? So how to calculate? So net resultant force on x direction means what? We have to refer what is the horizontal force in from the left hand side and what is the horizontal force from the right hand side. So if we observe this, here is the Fx1, that is the direction is towards the right hand side direction, and Fx2, direction towards the left hand side direction. That means both are in opposite direction. So we have to take, suppose we take here for the Fx1 positive sign, then for the Fx2 it is in opposite direction, we have to take here negative sign. So what is the resultant or net resultant force in the direction of x? That is Fx is equal to Fx1 minus Fx2. So if we calculate this, we will get here the answer 117,720 Newton. Now we will move for the resultant force in the direction of y. Now FY1 and FY2, so they are on both sides of this point O and at placed at equal distance, but what is the direction? So they are in same direction, that is the upward direction. So we have to add this, that is FY1 plus FY2. So when we add these two forces, we will get the answer 184,940 Newton. Then we will calculate, now this is the two components for the resultant force we get, that is Fx and Fy. So from this we can calculate the resultant force, that is under root of Fx square plus Fy square. So what is the answer here? That is 219,206 Newton. So this is the answer for the first question. Now what is the second question? That is we have to find out the direction of the resultant force. So when we resolve this force, that is this force F is in the inclined direction. So here is the horizontal component and this is the vertical component that we know. So I will say here is Fx, Fy and this is F. So for this direction of the resultant force, we will consider the angle made by this horizontal line for this F is theta. So if I take this Fy, that is starting from this force F, that is in this way, and this is the Fy, then this is the triangle, this is the right angle triangle. So we can say that tan theta is equal to this Fy by Fx. So this is the formula that we have to use. So we know Fy, we know Fx, then tan theta is equal to 1.5707 and theta is equal to tan inverse of this, that is 1.5707. So what is the answer here? 57°31". Now we will find out what is the location of the resultant force F. So for that we have to first find out what is the location of its horizontal component Fx and what is the location for the vertical component Fy. So how to calculate this? So we will consider here the distance of the horizontal force component Fx at a distance y from the bottom. So here from this bottom, that is this is the fixed surface, we will consider it is located at a distance y. So when we consider it, then we have the formula, that is Fx. That is this resultant force Fx multiplied by its distance from the bottom, that is y, which is equal to. So here this is the resultant of the two forces, that is Fx1 and Fx2, and both are in opposite direction. So we know that Fx is equal to Fx1 minus Fx2. So here we have to again multiply with this distance of Fx1 from the bottom and distance of Fx2 from the bottom. So we know what is the Fx1 distance, that is 2.67 from the top. So how to get this distance from the bottom? So this 4 minus 2.67, we will get the distance from the bottom. So we have to write which is equal to Fx1 in the bracket 4 minus 2.67. Minus, because here Fx2 we have to give minus sign. So minus Fx2 multiplied by. So what is the distance of Fx2? That is 1.33 from the top. So how to find out this bottom distance? That is this whole distance, 2 minus 1.33. So when we put all the values, because Fx is known, Fx1 is known and Fx2 is also known. So only one unknown term, that is y. So what is the distance here? Y is equal to 1.55 meter from the bottom. Now we will calculate the location of the vertical force component, that is Fy. So again we will consider here the Fy will act at a distance x from this line AOC. So this is the x, that is Fy is having distance x. So Fy is the resultant of Fy1 and Fy2. So again we have to multiply for this Fy1 with its distance from this AOC and Fy2 with its distance from AOC. So if we observe here, Fy into x is equal to Fy1 into 0.8488 minus Fy2 into 0.8488. Because from the AOC both are in opposite direction. Now here we have taken, this is the distance x, that is here this, if we consider, this is the distance Fy1 is at a distance x1 and here Fy2 is at a distance x2. So this x1 is in the left hand side direction and x2 is in the right hand side direction. That means both are in opposite direction. So suppose I will take here Fy1 with positive sign, then we have to take here for Fy2 negative sign, because the direction is opposite. So here we have to refer here the minus sign. So when we calculate this, so Fy is known, Fy1, Fy2 is also known. So what is the value of x? That is the unknown term, that is x is equal to 0.2829 meter from AOC. So this is the answer. Now what is the least weight of the cylinder? So if we observe this diagram, for this cylinder, this is the weight of the cylinder that will act in the downward direction. So I will show here, this weight of the cylinder will act in the downward direction and it should be getting balanced by the vertical force component, that is Fy. That is Fy1 plus Fy2. So here the least weight of the cylinder should be equal to vertical force component Fy, and which is equal to Fy1 plus Fy2. And we have to take least weight of cylinder, which is equal to Fy, and this is the known value that we have already calculated, that is 184,940 Newton, and this is the answer.